In this video presentation, I am going to show you how to use the two sample t-test as well as the two sample t-interval functions on the TI-83 calculator. So let's explore an example. Do psychology majors make less than sociology majors? The president of an alumni association decides to test his theory at the 5% level of significance. Of 25 recent graduates with a sociology degree, the mean salary was determined to be $49,644, with a standard deviation of $4,523. Of 20 recent graduates with a psychology degree, the mean salary was determined to be $45,836, with a standard deviation of $6,951. Is there sufficient evidence to suggest that the mean salary for persons with a psychology degree is less than the mean salary for persons with a sociology degree? Also, construct a 99% confidence interval for the difference between two means. To use the calculator, first you're going to press the stat key, then use the right arrow key to highlight tests. Next, you're going to select number 4, which is the two sample t-test. I'm going to go over this function first, and then I'll go over the two sample t-interval a little later. On this screen, you have two options. You can select data or stats. Since we have the actual statistics for this problem, I'm going to use the right arrow key to highlight stats and press enter. Next, I'll need to enter in the summary statistics for the two groups. Since the researcher wanted to determine if psychology majors make less than sociology majors, the direction of the alternative hypothesis is going to be less than. Thus, the psychology majors will be group 1. As a result, we're going to enter in the summary statistics for the psychology majors first, and then the information for the sociology majors second. So X bar 1 will be the mean of the psychology majors, which was 45,836. The standard deviation was 6,951, and the sample size was 20. For the sociology majors, the mean was 49,644. The standard deviation was 45,23, and the sample size was 25. Next, I'm going to select the direction of the alternative hypothesis, and again, it's less than, so using the right arrow key, I'm going to select the middle option and press enter. Now I need to select the option to make the test statistic pooled or not pooled, and by performing an F-test to determine if the variances are equal or not equal, it was determined that in this case, the variances were not equal. And therefore, the test statistic is not pooled, so I'm going to set pooled to no. I'm then going to scroll down to highlight calculate and press enter. And here you can see the value of the test statistic along with the p-value. Since the p-value is less than alpha, then we're able to reject the null hypothesis for this problem. Now we're going to use the two sample t-interval function on the calculator to construct a confidence interval. So once again, we're going to press stat, use the right arrow key to highlight tests, and scroll down until you see two sample T interval. On this screen, you'll notice that the summary statistics are already there, and that's because the calculator will transfer the information over. So you don't have to re-enter the information if you've already entered it for a previous example. So simply scroll down, select the level of confidence, which was 99. Again, pooled is set to no. Highlight calculate and press enter, and you'll see the values for the confidence interval.